Now let us quickly understand what are the functions of these parts. That's your forebrain, midbrain and the hindbrain. Firstly, let us see what are the functions of the forebrain. So this is the forebrain, students. This part is a forebrain. So it is one of the thinking part of the brain. Your thinking process, your thought process, your memory, everything is done by this forebrain, which has the cerebrum. This part is the cerebrum. And also, students, it has some regions in this cerebrum where it will take the sensory impulses from the various receptors. Once it takes the sensory impulses, it will try to store it. And after storing, when the situation demands, it will try to respond. So this is a function of the cerebrum. And how it is responding? It is passing the information to the motor areas. For example, now when I'm telling you to stand up, you are listening. There are senses, the hearing sense, which is taking the impulses to the cerebrum. And the cerebrum stores it and then it will tell, yes, there is a command for you to stand up. It will give the senses or the impulses back to the motor areas, that is your legs, and immediately you will stand up. This is how the signaling process takes place. And all the voluntary actions are controlled by the cerebrum. And there are regions which I was talking about. There are some hearing regions, there are some smelling regions. So in the cerebrum, there is a region for smelling. If you smell a rose, yes, it tells, yes, this is a rose and not any other flower. So that sense and that memory, it will try to give it to you. And about the sight, the seeing, yes, when you're seeing some toy, yes, this is a car, this is a bus, this is a tree, this is what is being taught. It is given to you in a memory wise. It will try to recollect and give you the answer. Now look at this particular image here. It is so cute, right? It's telling its tummy is full. So when do you feel that its tummy is full? If you keep on eating, sometimes you feel that, yes, it's full. I cannot eat more. No more I can eat. So who's helping you to give that sensation or the feeling? It is the cerebrum. Okay. And there are other functions like whatever you learn, the way you learn, it's because of the cerebrum. The way you think, the intelligent part of you, is because of the cerebrum. And also how you think and analyze or reason, ask why and how question, is because of the cerebrum. And whatever the memories you have, the good and bad memories, it's also because of the cerebrum. I hope the functions of cerebrum is clear to you all. Now let us move on to the midbrain. Students, midbrain is located over here. And midbrain have or controls the actions like the movement of head and neck. Yes, so the reflex movement of head and neck is controlled by the midbrain. And also look at this image. This is an eye. The left and right and up and down movement of the eye muscle is also controlled by the midbrain. And here you can see the pupil size is reducing and increasing. So this is also controlled by the midbrain. So these are some of the functions which is performed by the midbrain. Now quickly let us see about the hindbrain. Hindbrain controls all the involuntary movements like the respiration, the breathing process, and this process is controlled by the pons which is present in the hindbrain. And then you have, look at this image, students. This image has, doesn't it bring water in your mouth? It doesn't it give you the salivation? Yes, I'm getting it. I hope even you are getting the same. Look at this. This is the heartbeat. It's not under our control. The digestion process is also not under our control. So all these type of involuntary movements are controlled by the medullary region, which is present in the hindbrain. Like the salivation, even the vomiting, it's not under our control. The blood pressure is again not under our control. All these are controlled by the medulla, which is present in the hindbrain. There's yet another region in the hindbrain, that is the cerebellum. So this is the cerebellum, and cerebellum maintains the posture and balance of the body. Have you seen the drunken man? He is not able to walk properly. That's because the alcohol which he has consumed affects the cerebellum. So cerebellum, when it's not working, you won't be able to walk in a straight line. You will be moving in a crisscross manner or dancing when you walk. Also, the cerebellum helps you to ride the cycle or any vehicle. Also, it helps you to hold and pick the pencil when it is dropped. So these are the some of the functions which is performed by cerebellum. I hope you have understood. Let us have a quick recap about the functions of parts of the brain. So the parts of the brains are here and its functions is given over here. So the forebrain, which comprises of the cerebrum, helps you to think, store memories. It senses all the sensory organs and gives the messages to the motor nerves. Moving on to the midbrain. Midbrain regulates the movement of eye, size of the pupil, and the movement of head and neck. The hindbrain has these three parts. It's pons, medulla, and cerebellum. Pons, it regulates the respiration. Medulla, it involves all the involuntary actions like the salivation, vomiting, digestion, heartbeat, and the blood pressure. And cerebellum maintains the posture and balance of the body. So what are some of the values which you learn from today's topic, that is the brain, is that you have to train your brain to think positively, have good thoughts, students, exercise your brain to have good memories. Also, you have to exercise your brain to have good memory power. Always coordinate with others, like your brain coordinates with rest of your body parts. Always thank God for a beautiful brain He has given to you. And this is a small lesson for you. You'll be sleeping, your brain tells, wake up, you have to do your assignment. That means your brain is very good. It will always keep reminding you to get up, study, you have to score more, but you will be sleeping. So try to listen to your brain and start acting. Thank you, students. I hope you enjoyed the class. Have a good day.